Yo, welcome to the 1804 show, chapter 2. I'm your host, Dollar Wheel, and this is episode 602. Yeah, feels so good to be back. And make sure y'all hit that like button. Make sure y'all can't even talk tonight. Yeah, I haven't done this in some minute. Can't even talk tonight. What's wrong with me? But yeah, make sure y'all hit that like button. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, the 1804 Chapter 2. Now let's begin. Yeah, I just want to thank everybody who've been supporting me. Just want to thank everybody who've been showing me love and just making sure that I hit my margin, hit my milestone. 600 episodes under my belt. It's been a pleasure. It's been such a blessing to reach this magnitude. You feel me? So tonight I want to talk about it's me versus me. And it just, what I mean by that is no matter what happens, only I can stop me. And only you can stop you. And no matter what, you gotta keep going. You always gotta make sure that you believe in yourself. Because these people and this fame and whatever you're trying to do is always gonna be temporary. And you gotta make sure that you have a plan. And any, everything you do, always have a plan. Always have an exit in anything. And just know that one day you can be on top, next day you can be alone, can be by yourself, because you can't depend or count on people who's just want to be around you because you got some fame or you got a buzz out here. Because a whole lot of people just love to dick ride. And I'm always honest and I'm always humble. And I just never forget everything that I've gone through. Being homeless, being broke, being hungry, being dusty. You know what I'm saying? So I'll just always be grateful for everything as far as with the show and everything. All the people that I met, all the interviews that I've conducted, even though a lot of times I get overlooked, but it's all good. Because I feel like God has the final say and God is in control. So I'm just grateful for just every episode, man. Every video. To be able to showcase my gifts to people, man, and do it in a positive way. I'm grateful for all the Hollywood people I met, the local people that I stumbled upon. People that I met along the way, people that I've known for years that came on my platform. I thank you guys from the bottom of my heart. And just like I said in the status last night, it wasn't like I was sad or it wasn't like I was trying to explain myself. If anything, I was just pointing out the obvious and speaking in general and just say, like, underdogs have it the hardest. The people that's not popular or the people that isn't supported like that. But you got those people, like rappers or people that's low vibrational, dumbing down your children and stuff like that, and making it worse and making it painful for the youth or whatever. They get all the support. They get all the love. They don't do anything for the communities except promote violence and promote death and promote unproductivity. You know what I'm saying? So it's just us, the ones who are intellectual, who are smart, who are on our shit, stand on business. We get ridiculed a lot. And I just tell myself every day that I'm doing the right thing, 'cause I could have been famous if I wanted to, but I stand on integrity. I stand on morals. I stand on rules. You know what I'm saying? 'Cause all money ain't good money. But if anything, I'm just happy that I was able to teach my people history and just do my best in my own way to make the world a better place and my city a better place. 'Cause I feel like I have impacted so many people and people have impacted me. I learned a whole lot from people's interviews and testimonies, experiences that I had apply that into my everyday life, 'cause it gives you a different perspective on how to conduct yourself and how to carry yourself. 'Cause we like to be bitter, we like to speak negative, excuse me, about ourselves to the point that we feel like we had it so bad and we had it so hard, but a lot of times we haven't. A lot of times we were spared. And when you think about it, your worst day could be somebody else's best day, and somebody else's worst day can be your best day. So at the end of the day, it's always a new day to make it right and to fix things and to gain a second chance. 'Cause second chances don't come every day. And a whole lot of people are walking into their karma or living in it to the point that they can't escape. They took advantage of people. They try to play with people. And this was their outcome. And just special shout outs, man, to everybody who had helped me in the beginning. Everybody who has ever donated, just anybody who ever contribute to the business or just contribute to my life, I thank y'all so much. My last interview, every time I watch it, brought me to tears, man, 'cause I was able to talk to a man who saved my life, a man who I met when I was 14 years old, lost, out of control, angry, always fighting. And he was the first man that told me that I could be anything that I wanted to be. He the first man that told me that I can achieve all great things. And been the most consistent person in my life. And just over 20 years later, just bring him on my platform and thank him for loving me unconditionally. 'Cause nowadays love is based on what you can do for me, what can you offer me, how much money you got, where you work at, what kind of car you drive. You know what I'm saying? Everybody wants to love you when you on top of the world. But we get so caught up and distracted by our goals and dreams and aspirations and abysses to the point that the best things in life are free. But one thing I will say back when I was broke was I was able to enjoy life. I was able to learn about myself and think. And I just think that the world should always be like that, but people operate on money. They love money so bad to the point that they would even steal, kill, rob for it. And it's unfortunate, but I'm just grateful for the second chance God gave me, the moment I repented. 'Cause I used to not want to be anything and do anything, and I repented. 'Cause laziness is a sin, you know what I'm saying? So I was able to repent and just allow God to guide me to my purpose and through my pain and through my depression and through being betrayed, through being hurt, through being backstabbed, and through it all, you know what I'm saying? And I was fortunate to find such a good outlet. 'Cause I know, like, it's the holiday season, everybody jolly, everybody in a Christmas spirit and stuff like that, but everybody isn't in a Christmas spirit. Everybody isn't going to see the people that they love, especially the ones that have passed on. But I just happy that everybody else happy and everybody get the opportunity to spend time with their families and to do what they love and make their kids happy on Christmas morning. And I'm gonna be happy Christmas morning. I got my mother back in my life. We're talking. And that's all I wanted. 'Cause I love my mother. My mother is my heart. She's my key to everything. And I feel appreciated and just grateful to still have my mom. I know a lot of people don't have their mothers, and I'm learning to be patient and learning to let go of the past. And so I could just move on with my life and be happy, you know? But I learned a lot during this year, and just knowing that I have to take accountability of some things and just learn how to not place high expectations on human beings, because we are human. And us being sons and daughters, we like to think our parents are superhuman, but they're human and they make mistakes. They say things out of anger at times. We say things out of anger at times. But people just need to understand that it's not a whole lot of people in this lifetime that will be here for you and stick around when you're at your lowest. And I can admit, when I was at my lowest, she was there for me. And I'm grateful for the people that's not here anymore. You did me a favor. You know, not everybody get the chance to survive or to be away from their fake friends unscathed, you know? And every day I just pray to God to just protect me. You know, whatever shield you got on me, keep it on me. 'Cause I want to live a long time. I want to be a grandfather. I want to live so long so I can watch my nieces and nephew, a godson, and my wife and my kids. I want to be around that long, you know. I want to bury my mother. I want to continue my bloodline. I want to just go see the world, travel, meet millions of people. And I'm going to do that someday because I'm the alpha and the omega of my life. It's just, life be lifing, but also life is a blessing. Life is rewarding. When you think about just all the people that you outlived, you start to just really think of a whole lot of things in a good way, and things don't be so bad anymore. You don't even be upset no more or that uptight. Because I'm here for a reason, and you are here for a reason too. And I'm just glad I was just able to just prosper and to do such great work. Because I feel like I gave my all. Even if I haven't gotten a lot of views on certain videos, I gave my all. And I don't have any hard feelings or animosity, excuse me, towards anybody, because whenever I big myself up, it's because of me. It's because of the people that's preying on me. I don't know who it is, and I'll never say no names, but whoever preying on me always revealed themselves. They always show who they truly are. And I don't know what's their problem, but I'm just living my life. I can live my life while you continue to exist, but I'm living. And I have no beef. I have no notion to take your place or no interior motive, no hidden agenda. If anything, I'm just trying to change my financial situation. I'm trying to change my family situation. I'm just trying to be the man of my family, because I am the man of my family. And I'm not letting nobody shit on me and put me in a particular category, because I'm authentic, I'm original. I've done so much in a little time. And I hate when people try to tell me how to conduct my business or try to tell me how to conduct myself. I feel like I'm very professional. I'm a hard worker. My work ethic is unmatched. I'm on my fifth mixtape, by the way. Shout out to everybody who wanted to get on there, and just great, talented people. And I feel like if I was so fake, none of this would have happened. I would have not lasted this long. I'd have been exiled, you know what I'm saying? Or ostracized, you know? But I'm still here. I'm still thriving. Can't wait for the new year, because I have so much in store. I have so much I want to do. New episodes, new guests, new topics, new everything. I'm just glad, just knowing that I have a fan base and I have people that's backing me up, people that's supporting me. And to all my new subscribers, I thank y'all for subscribing to me. New people to follow me, all socials. Appreciate y'all. I never thought I would have been doing this 10 years ago, not even 5 years ago. Never thought I would be doing this, but hey, we all go through a metamorphosis, and this is mine. I was a caterpillar, Now I'm a butterfly, if that makes any sense to you guys. But yeah, anytime I big myself up, it's to kill the old me. It's to destroy the perception of those people who preyed on my downfall, who wished that upon me. You was wrong. 'Cause at the end of the day, I'm a survivor. I'm not a victim. I'm a survivor and I'm an assessor. So I'm a just keep going, keep growing. 'Cause at the end of the day, nobody can destroy me but the man in the mirror. And I have to look at that man every day. Whether it's washing my face, brushing my teeth, fixing my hair, I have to look at that man and hold that man accountable. So, but yeah, I'm out, guys. Hit like, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell for future notifications, and I'm out. Tune in for the next episodes because I'm finna go harder. And if you like to donate to the Cash App, Cash App $ the 1804 show. And I'm out. Have a good evening. Peace.